In this video, we are going to create a music poster design inside of Photoshop, which is looking very simple and creative. You can use this technique to create a different type of poster design. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Pixartor, and without any further ado, let's jump into the Photoshop and get started. Alright, so here we are in the Photoshop, and if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more interesting videos. And let's take a new page and get started. So just go to this file, click on new, and set the width of this page 2000 pixel, height 2000 pixel, resolution 72 pixel per inches. Set this color mode RGB color and click on create. And we have to import an image file. So just go to this folder. And I'm going to use this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I have given a link in the description. So just go to the link in the description and download this image if you want, and just drag this image on this blank page. Hold Alt on the keyboard and fit this image according to the page. Just like that. And after that, just double click on this layer and call it image. Now you can delete this white background. So click on this lock button and unlock this layer and hit delete button. And now I'm going to make this image black and white. So what we have to do, just select this image layer, click on this adjustment option, and here we have to select this black and white effect. Now let's apply one more thing. Just click on this adjustment icon, and here we have to select this brightness and contrast. Select this option and let's increase the contrast value. So let's adjust the contrast value and set this value something around 90%, and it's looking much more interesting, as you can see. And after that, we have to type a text right over here, which is most important thing for this tutorial. So just select this text tool. We have to select a font style first. So just go to this window and check this option character, and here we have this character property, and let's select a font style first. So in this case, I am using this Null's Hook font style, which is one of my favorite font style, and I have given a link in the description. So if you want this font style, then go to the link in the description. Alright, I'm gonna set it to bold. Click over here and let's type anything that you want. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and we have to select this pure white color. Hit OK. Now let's increase the size of this font. So let's set this value 300 pixel. Now it's looking perfect. And after that, we have to set this line spacing. So just click on this icon, and I'm gonna set this value 250. All right, and now it's looking perfect. And after that, we have to down the character spacing. So this is the character spacing option. I'm gonna set this value something around negative 200. Now it's looking perfect. And after that, select this move tool, and we have to align this text in the center, just like this. And after that, we have to split each text character in different layer. So what we have to do, just select this text layer, hit Ctrl J on the keyboard to duplicate, or you can also right click on this text layer and click on duplicate layer right over here. All right, now select the second copy and select this text tool, double click on that, hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and type first character first. So I'm gonna type D. All right. For better visibility, just select this bottom text layer, and you can change the color. Now select this move tool. Let's place this D character over on this red one. And now just select this top layer, right click on that, click on duplicate layer. And this is gonna be the second character A. So let's type A, hit OK, and select this text tool, double click on this, type A by holding shift, select this move tool, let's place this second character over on this red one, and now let's scale it up a little bit, just like this. And after that, select this second character, go to FX, click on this drop shadow. And let's apply a drop shadow effect on this second character. So we have to set this opacity maybe 50%. Let's set the distance value 10 pixel, spread 0, size 50, which is looking awesome for me. All right, hit OK. You can adjust these drop shadow setting according to you. Hit OK. And after that, we have to create separate layers for all the characters in the text. So what we have to do is select this top layer, hit Control J on the keyboard to duplicate, or you can also right click and click on duplicate layer and select this top layer, select this text tool, double click on this last character, type the third one. So hit R on the keyboard, select this move tool. Let's drag this R on this red one and placed it like this, and we will get this type of effect. All right, so we have to repeat same process for all the characters. So I'm gonna do this in fast forward. All right, so it's done. And after that, we have to select all the single character layer, just like this, hit Control G to create a group. Now, this is the text group. Double click on that, let's call it text, hit enter, and now we can delete this referent text layer by hitting delete button. Now let's turn on the text group layer, and finally we have this interesting text effect as you can see. And now we have to type the music producer name over here. So select this text tool, click over here and type your music company name. Hit Control A to highlight all, and for this one we have to select black color, hit OK, and let's down the size. So I'm gonna set this value maybe 50 pixel, and I'm gonna set this character spacing auto, maybe set this 0, line spacing auto. All right, and we have to select a different font style for that. So for this one I'm gonna use this Gotham black font style. All right, now select this bottom line, and for the bottom line we have to select a different font style. So I'm gonna select this Gotham maybe medium. All right, select this move tool, let's drag this text and place it right over here maybe. And as you can see, we have some disturbing element which is disturbing this text. So we have to erase this black section. So what we have to do, just select this image and we have to pick this foreground color from here, hit OK, and select this paint brush tool, select this soft brush, take a new layer, and we have to erase this section just like this. It's looking perfect. And after that we have to type all the details of this music album over here. So select this text tool again, click on the screen, and let's type your singer, composer, lyrics artist, and basically we have to type all the details of the music. Alright, now select this move tool, let's place the text right over here, just like this. Now let's make this text something fancy. So what we have to do, just select this singer and let's set this size of the text maybe 30 pixel. Let's arrange the text. Now it's looking a little fancy. Arrange the text in the center of this, just like this. All right, after that select this text layer and drag and drop over on the text layer, and now we have to set the opacity of this text maybe 50% or 60%. It's looking perfect. Let's do the same thing for this one. So select this text layer and set the opacity maybe 80%. 80% is good, and now it's looking awesome. And that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon for more interesting videos. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.